構ってくれっていう風に。
I kept saying in my head, please stop, please stop now, please.、ね、
もう外に飛び出
して。I ran outside but was unable to stay standing up.Because the ground was shaking so much, I got down on my hands and knees and waited for it to pass. This earthquake was extremely long, so I thought a tsunami would come. When the earthquake hit, I had left my house and was driving. So I wasn't sure if it was an earthquake or just a car. But when I saw the way people were moving and the building shaking, I knew it was an earthquake.
All of a sudden, the room started shaking.I grabbed my computer so it wouldn't fall and waited for the shaking to stop. I thought for sure a tsunami was going to come. I started yelling at people in the office to run to safety as soon as possible.
It was just an instantaneous decision I made to get the camera.I filmed inside the office. But because the shaking continued, I decided to go out and film there.
I started filming on my iPhone at 2:49 p.m. And by 2:55, I was on top of the hill, so it only took a few minutes.
ですから数分の間に移動が可能だったわけですけれども。
When I got up there, the town didn't look any different than usual. It just looked like a normal, quiet town.
そのまま当たったんですけども。
車車内で。I did look at the information being relayed to my car navigation system.
情報とかは見てたんですけれども。
But,Well, I'm originally from an inland area, so I didn't have the common sense that there's a danger of a tsunami after an earthquake happens. It did look normal. What's it called? Mob psychology? There were lots of people there, so it seemed like a safe place. It didn't seem like a tsunami was going to hit. I don't think anyone knew.
誰も分かんなかったですね。
その時点でもやっぱり私は
While I was filming,
津波の異
常 I still didn't think about the tsunami. A fire truck was driving around the area, telling people to evacuate.
それで避難を呼びかけたり。
で、 The local people began to head for higher ground.
高台の方に移動したんですけれども。
その時はもう。
At that time,The first thing the local people did after the earthquake was leave their houses. The nearest place to evacuate is that hill over there. Okay then, let's go. That's the kind of thing I heard. The people who had made it to the top of the hill were looking out towards the sea.Pointing at the ocean and asking, Is that a tsunami? They were urging people below to hurry up and evacuate to the hill as fast as possible.
私が車で移動してる途中で、
When I was in my car, there were a lot of people still walking. I opened the window and yelled that there was a tsunami coming.
移動してました。
津波来てます!津波来てます!
川を見たらもうそばまで来てたので。
When I looked at the river, the water rose up so fast. It was like it was next to me.
気を取られてたら。
It all happened so quickly.
川とその川の逆流と。
The river flowing backwards, and the tsunami overflowing into the city.
海から直接来るのが街の中で交錯して。
From the point where I saw the tsunami myself to the point where I got to the top and looked down at the town, it was completely different. There was so much water, it felt like it all happened in an instant. The sound of buildings crashing against each other, the sound of wooden structures crunching.There's just no way to say it. It's difficult to comprehend as a reality. Was it fear? It was like a film.
本当に1時間とかその発生当時発生前までは普通に
The people who had been calmly working
仕事をしてた
Just an hour earlier
その場そこで生活
The people who lived here
ことにがもう
In just seconds
この一瞬
All of that was gone
全く違う姿に変わっていくっていうことに
Then the water started rising. But I still thought it would be okay because of the levee. But as time passed, the water rose above the levee. I saw what happened during the Chile earthquake. And all I could do is flash back to those images. I knew this was going to be bad.
どんどんどんどん水が上がるから。
I don't really remember the sounds as the water rose up.
覚えてないんですけど。
But I remember thinking how much I wish it would stop.
そんなふうに思いましたね。
ダメだ。おいおいおい。
There's nothing you could do but pray to God.
自分たちではどうにもならない。
We couldn't do anything in the face of such immense power.
まくられますから。
There was nothing to do but yell and scream.
まきながら叫びながら。
We couldn't contain ourselves.
抑えるのにはじっとはしられない。
おい、止めてくれ。止めてくれ。
Then I saw people in cars trying to reverse away and getting washed down the street by the water. I saw terrible things like that. I knew it was going to get worse. As the water got higher, houses and people just got swept up and washed away. It was incredibly sad.
I was worried about my home, so I watched from some stone stairs nearby. Then I saw my house and car washed away. The neighborhood was rapidly engulfed. I couldn't believe it.It had only been 3 years since I finally managed to build my own home. It was surreal. Everything we had built just got washed away. Just looking at that was frightening. It's hard to describe the fear I felt. I just don't know how to say it.
よくわからない。
今まで味わったことないショックだから。
I had never experienced this kind of shock.
Even though we saw the car passing by to warn us, we didn't think the tsunami would actually reach us because we lived quite far from the ocean and we were on the hill.
地震が来た時点で津波の危険があるというのは
I already knew that huge earthquakes could cause a tsunami, so I knew I had to evacuate as soon as possible.
頭にありました。ここに上がる階段のところで
As I was going up the stairs that led to the high school, I saw a dust cloud, which meant that houses were being destroyed by the tsunami. I knew a lot of damage was being done, and I tried to capture the series of events.
感じ取って、
まあ、うちはそういう津波にまつわる
Because my family has a particular connection to tsunami.When this tsunami came, I decided I wanted to record it for posterity. So I climbed the stairs halfway up the building and started taking photos. When I looked at the train station, there were buildings just flowing over the top of it. Where would it stop?I still had it in my head that my house would survive, but it just kept pouring in. Is it still coming?
When I looked, water and debris were flowing over the tracks and through the station. I hurried in through the back door and went to get my daughter. I yelled at her, "We have to run!"
Most people were so shocked and speechless, while others were becoming hysterical as their family members hadn't come out of their houses when the tsunami hit.
The first thing that got sucked up was my shed. I thought, it's just a shed. Oh well. At least the house is okay. And just as I thought that, the house went with it. The things I was seeing were completely unimaginable.
When we started running, we assumed that we would be able to outrun it. But what happened was that the wave completely swallowed us up. I was desperate. Fortunately for me, soon after I was swallowed by the wave, a roof drifted towards me and went under my body, as if it was trying to pick me up. I was on top of the roof, and the wave took me all the way to the high school. People who were by the school saw me and pulled me down.
Most of the residents were already at the emergency evacuation centers. I was on the fire truck and was directing people over the loudspeaker. After a while, I drove towards the levee and checked the water level from the top of the floodgate. When I got to the top of the levee, I saw the water had already receded a lot. From there, I called out for people to run away. Once the waves hit the bottom part of the levee, the water shot up the side very suddenly. I probably only had 5 seconds or so to get away. If I got on the truck 20 seconds later, I don't think I'd be here today.
Come on! カー使って、早く誘導しなきゃならないなというふうな。
I knew my duty was to direct people to evacuate, but I didn't turn off the camera.
その辺今から考えるとどういう。
I'm actually not really sure why I kept filming.
いたのかっていうのは自分自身明確な答えは見出せないでいます。
みんなが堤防越えた！ダメダメダメダメ！堤防越えた！堤防越えてきたから！堤防越えた！
で。
We had a levee that was 5 meters tall that we thought could protect against a tsunami. We based all our evacuation areas and exercises on this assumption. As a firefighter, as the father of a child,I can never forgive the fact that I let children die. I let elderly die. I can never forget. We knew a tsunami was coming. We could feel it.
It
suddenly got really silent.
It's
hard to imagine such a sudden silence.
It
was like all sound had disappeared.
I
remember how ominous it was.
It seemed like my husband knew the tsunami was coming after the earthquake. After the Chile earthquake, the tsunami was only 1 meter tall. I think he thought the tsunami this time would be the same or a bit higher. So he was interested in filming. He likes to shoot video and carries his camera all the time.
A fire truck came around, and I heard them yelling at people to evacuate. The tsunami came about 40 minutes after the earthquake. So I went around the fish market towards the riverbank and started filming on my mobile phone.The levee was about 3 meters high. I didn't think the tsunami would ever be big enough to come over that. So I kept filming. I didn't think it was going to be such a big tsunami. On the Okawa River, there were small pleasure boats that were moored. The boats got pushed along and made a crunching sound when they collided with each other.When I saw overturned boats coming towards me, I knew something wasn't right. Everyone around was yelling, "Hurry up, hurry up, run!"
I thought that we were in danger. So I shouted to my husband, you have to come to higher ground. I saw electric wires being cut and falling down. It was scary, and I shouted that everyone needed to come higher.
I was heading to the emergency staircase at the school. And I went and looked over, and I could see the water rising up over the bank.
I thought I might be in trouble here when the wave came over the levee. Still, I wasn't too worried because I thought it was only a little bit of water. But I was wrong, since quite a lot of water suddenly gushed over. I was on my bike, and I was heading towards the nearby high school.
You weren't just running, you were running for your life. Just as it spilled over, I began climbing the staircase. I kept climbing while filming behind me. It happened so quickly. If I'd gone any slower, I don't think I would have made it.
There was too much water, and I couldn't get to the school buildings. So I just climbed up a tree. Watching from the school, you could see our homes in the distance, disappearing under the waves. As it rose higher, you could see people who weren't able to escape. You could see cars just get completely swallowed up by the waves. We were really afraid that the school would get washed away too. All we could do was watch. We were just shocked, speechless. It felt like the end. We had lost everything.
Shit.
I felt the terrible power of nature. I was not expecting that nature could be this dreadful and that it could change so much. All we could do was watch what was happening. It was so horrible. I don't know what to say.
Everyone was looking in the direction of the heli pier and screaming. For a second, I had forgotten that I had my camera with me, but I quickly remembered. I used the zoom function to see what people were looking at and saw waves of water. I knew straight away that it was a tsunami. I saw piles of cars being swallowed by the muddy water and coming towards us very quickly. It happened really fast. To be honest, I didn't expect the water to come all the way to where I was. There were many buildings between where the cars were and me, so I thought it would stop. It had never occurred to me that the tsunami would reach us. It was a big road in the middle of town. You would never have realized it was actually a coastal area. You could say I was naive, but even just before it hit, there were police out directing traffic. I could see the tsunami coming towards those cars stuck in traffic. I was really worried about them, but there was nothing I could do. Some people were screaming as loud as they could to warn the people in the cars down below, but they couldn't have heard them when I think about it now.
The first time I realized a tsunami was going to hit was when I actually saw it myself. I looked in my rearview mirror and saw an even larger wave than the one in front of me. I didn't know what to do. People were running out of their cars. I suppose that's about it. I think everyone was really panicking. It was incredibly quick. It probably took only 10 or 20 seconds from the moment when the water hit my car to the car being washed away. There's video of a woman being washed away right before my eyes. At that time, I thought I was going to die. It was kind of strange, but I didn't really feel panicky myself. I was quite calm. I thought, that's how things go, so I might as well do as much as I can. I decided just to sit inside and wait. I figured that even if my car got swept up by the tsunami, it might land in some place and I might be able to float to safety.
I saw many cars being swallowed by the water and swept away. But there wasn't anything we could do. We even talked amongst ourselves if there was a way to help, but nothing could be done.
I had it in my mind that I'd use the car to protect me as long as possible. The car would float to somewhere safe. Or, if that was impossible, when the opportunity came, I'd jump out and float to safety. I figured I'd have to swim for it. Finally, my face hit the surface, and I could breathe.
Right around 6 p.m., it started to snow. It was too cold to be outside. We had all gone back inside to the classrooms to warm up. Right around that time, we could see fire. It looked like all of Kesennuma was drenched in flames. Even from the top of the school, it seemed like we were right in front of it. It was like being in hell. We thought any people who had survived the tsunami would surely be killed by the flames instead.
The damage this time was really immense. But we have to stand back up and stand taller than we did before. We should be mentally prepared for that, living where we do. Building houses, building factories. Everyone knows doing this puts us at risk. A disaster is going to come, but when it does come, we have to rebuild. I feel very strongly about that.
I don't know what's going to happen to our town.
People are asking, so what happens now? People have some belongings now, things they've received from others. But there are still questions about work or how long we can all live in this temporary housing. When we leave the housing, what kind of lifestyle will we end up living?
I have no home and I'm almost 70 years old. I don't have any savings and it's difficult to think about what I'll do from here. It's something I worry about every day. I think everyone who lost their homes feels the same way.
They say that the elderly speak of the past and youth speak of the future. That's what we have to embrace. Older people are always going on about the way things were, but we have to think about how to build a new Kesennuma. We have to focus on the new. I think, from now on, I must live having the weight of those lives on my shoulders. I have responsibility for that, and responsibility to build a new town here. Volunteers are helping us with the clearing up. But there's yet to be any kind of support or care for people's mental health. Amongst the people I know, there are probably a dozen or so experiencing trauma. This is where I was born and raised. When I go up to the mountains, I realize they don't suit me. Kesennuma is where I can see the Pacific. It's between the mountains and the sea. Yes, I'd really like to stay here. The sea is beautiful, but still scary. I don't know how much time I need till I don't feel scared.
Our town was covered with water and completely swallowed by the powerful tsunami. I honestly couldn't comprehend what it was. In my mind, I kept trying to make sense of what happened.
My feelings about the sea haven't changed, and I think it's normally a very kind thing. It helps us, and it has helped us for years. I don't feel like I despise it. From this disaster, I think, perhaps it's us who made the mistake, living in an area vulnerable to tsunami. But at the same time, we need to think of ways to prevent this kind of thing from happening.